church that brings me closer to my Savior. Little bit of heaven, a whole lot of love left behind. So put a candle in the window and let it set your heart aglow.
Good morning, good morning. This is Dick Shoemaker. The show is Rise and Shine. Are you warm? Well, hadn't gotten as cold as everyone thought it was going to be, but it will get to that point eventually, and maybe even a bit more. But I'm glad to be here. A little bit chilly coming down the road, but, you know, have a good day. I guess the schools are all opening on time, and everything else is working out pretty well. We've got some folks in this morning to talk to, but let's first take a quick look at the newspaper, and as soon as everyone's here, we'll meet our guests. And I was looking at this big poster that I have here, the Snow Creek Rescue Squad. Oh, my goodness. Let's see. February 4th is a blood drive there. February 4th. They send me a notice that even an old man like me can read. You know, what do you think? Penhook, Snow Creek Road. A lot of good people out there doing great things. That's February 4th from 9 till 1, if you want to write that down. And the VFW post 10840 out at Snow Creek. That's a nice place out there. I've been out there for meetings and to eat and so forth. So, but they're running a blood drive Saturday, February 4th from 9 till 1. I just, see? Send me a small note so that I wouldn't forget. Looking at the front page of the newspaper, Franklin County School System files its FOIA. There's a lot of different things happening with the schools, and they're still trying to figure out the best way to go. And a little bit interesting there, because the school board, the some of the supervisors and some of everybody, a little bit of difference of feeling. But we know that they're all working forward for Franklin County and Rocky Mount, so we will be waiting to see what happens. Got a picture of Talmadge Mitchell on the front page with a big map. Wow. He's been around for a year. Good morning, sir, and best wishes. Nice picture. And then at the bottom of the page, Franklin News Post is on the bandwagon. Forecasters predict snow locally this weekend. I would suggest if they didn't, they'd be the only ones that aren't. But if you'll recall, the snow was due to start a little bit earlier. And we don't know quite why it's not, but that's all right. It'll get here, he said, with a certain amount of positiveness. Don't forget, let me see, what day is that? That's coming up on the 16th at the Pig River Community Center. The Martin Luther King Jr. Breakfast, 8 a.m. We had those folks in the last show, and there's a lot of different people involved, and I got through all of it. What happens at the Pig River Community Center is pretty amazing. You remember when that was built a few years ago, and Say, why are they doing that? My goodness. And now we use it tremendously. It's the 15th annual Martin Luther King breakfast, which means that's been there now 15, 16 years. So if you haven't been in that building, take advantage of it. Get in, look around, see what you got. It's up to be rented if you need to use something like that. But I think you'll enjoy being there. But that breakfast is January 16th at 8 a.m. That's a great thing to participate in. Judge Charles Becton from Durham will be the speaker, and Will Smith will be the speaker for the youth. This is an interesting breakfast because they're going to actually do it differently. After 14 years of doing it the same way. Now, what it means is that they're going to have a breakfast for the youth grades 6 to 12, and also the typical Martin Luther King breakfast. They're going to use two rooms out there, but whichever one you're going to go or be involved in, go ahead and plan on being there. So I'll continue to remind you of that and bring you up to date as I am told. Got in my library events. Now, that's a pretty neat situation. I really haven't studied it, but as usual, they send me all the good things that are going on in the library, and you want to take a look at this. That's a bunch of stuff. I am so grateful to the Franklin County Public Library System. I am so happy with all the stuff that's going on. Anybody that says they don't want to go to the library, anybody says you don't need to go to the library, anybody says they don't want to go to the library, think about it. I got it yesterday in the mail, and I haven't had a chance to look at it, but between the two branches, main office and Westlake, there are so many, well, let me just go down the list for, called the Senior Scholars Book Club at the main library. Winter reading programs. Start January 10th. Mahjong. You know what Mahjong is? I did it once. It wasn't mine. Anything that's spelled Mahjong, I don't think I want, but I'm sorry. But that's on the January 9th, 23rd, 30th at 1 o'clock in the small meeting room of the main library. Homework helper. Okay. Same days, practically. Lego Club. Your library does a lot. And they have this Franklin County Library's little pamphlet here that you can get and read. Adult Winter Reading Program. And let me tell you, folks, this is a wonderful time to do that. Wrap up with a good book. Now, what do you think about that? Now, if you got to go to work, I probably wouldn't wrap up a good book before I went to work, but January 10th through February 25th is that theme, wrap up with a good book for ages 18 plus. The library's got so many things going on. I'm going to get into this a little bit later. Matter of fact, if I can get them down here, Sue, if you're watching. Winter reading beginning, what is that, 4 more days? Learn to play Mahjong. I don't even know what it is. Well, you know, I can remember people in my family doing that years ago, but it wasn't my kind of thing, and then I forgot about it. homework helper on Mondays at the library. They are doing us a great job. Now, I'm going to have to read this a little bit. They've given me a homework assignment. How do you like that? Haven't had one of them for a long time. And those events are at the main library, some of them, and some of them are out at the Westlake branch. Like the Lego Club is at the Westlake branch. Paper flower making at the Westlake branch. Senior Scholars Book Club at the Essig Center. So many things going on. We are so fortunate. There's a also coming up on January 21, the Resolve 5K, 10K race. That's the the YMCA is putting that on. Do you really think anybody wants to go out in this weather and do a 5K or a 10K? Yes, I do. I know. There's people. They do that no matter what. I think age is on my side. I'm still here, but I don't run a lot. The Snowball 5K, the Winterfest 10-miler at Bernard's Landing, February 18th. Smith Mountain Lake Dam, that's got a real cold one, April 1. That's, you never know about the weather on that at that time of the year, but at the Smith Mountain 5K and the dam, pardon me, that says it right, the dam 50K. And all the rest of the dam, no, never mind, I better leave that one alone. But whoa, that takes place at the big dam out there. Parent-child swim lessons are going on. This is a very interesting time of year. A lot of things that we don't do. Sunday, as in this weekend, Shadow Grass with Presley Barker in concert. The Reynolds Homestead will open the 2017 American Music Series. That's going to be fun. That's a group, Presley Barker, Kitty Amaral, Clay Russell, Luke Morris, Kaiser George, making good music. Ladies' Night Out. Thank you, Carilion Clinic. I didn't want to go anyway. January 12th through February 16th. Can you run as fast as a lady? Ah, I better not even talk about that. But this says on that day you will learn to infuse your body with energy, increase your ability to burn unwanted calories, get inspired with a I can do anything attitude. The ladies' night out fitness parties will include club dancing, fitness challenges, door prizes, healthy cooking recipes, and more. January 12th through February 16th. It's at the Essig Center in town. Don't forget, if you want to honor a veteran, you can do that by ordering a brick and have it endorsed, paid, and you can go over there and see it. And it's an amazing place and a wonderful opportunity for you to buy a brick and have it posted at the Franklin County Veterans Memorial. You know where that is, in town, right across the street from Johnny Singleton's Market. That's the best landmark I can tell you right there. But you'll see it. They're updating a lot of that. So, doing some things. The Veterans Memorial Commission does a world of good out there for us. Let's see, schools. I've been notified by a firm that their elementary school, we are invited to become a volunteer, a mentor. If you have spare time and you're reasonably close to, I don't know that I recommend coming from Smith Mountain Lake to Ferrum, but if you want to, you can, and become a volunteer, a lunch buddy, mentors in the schools, and this one is from Firm, so that's a good place to be. Got notice of professional senior companion care. Old friend of mine, Lee Prom, she is the granny nanny. You know, some ladies don't like to be called a granny nanny, but this is a kind of a different thing. If you have somebody that needs professional senior companion, do daily chores and to-dos, lighthouse, housekeeping, and travel, and going on social affairs, call Lee at 352-8631 and she will arrange it, okay? The 365 Small Business Circle, that will run from January 1 through, are you ready for this, December 31st. Lots of things you can do. We got a sail aboard the Hoo Doggy. What's a Hoo Doggy? Oh, while I'm turning these over, have you picked up your playbook? Parks and Rec. This is probably the best of these. I remember we were the place that this was introduced a few years ago, and it was wonderful. And the library has grown, and everybody is having good luck. They are, as a matter of fact, they listed all the people that work at the library, and a brief story about them, a couple of new people, and some of the things that are open for you to do. And I appreciate it, being the old man that I am. The first 1, 2, 3, 4 pages are activities for 50 plus. Now, you could look back in my career and find out when I was 50 plus. I was still president of the bank at that point. And I guess I didn't retire for 15 years after that from the bank. And but long about that time, I started coming down here. I guess it was even before that. I don't know, I gotta ask Steve. But what is going on for the seniors in our community? Wow, tax preparation, open gym, pickleball, senior scholars. There's just a whole lot of things. Get out, get one. Now, these are free. I remember when they started with these. I think they called me, and I gave them a big, big, big positive on it. They're going to have a Tai Chi Chuan class. I wonder what Chuan means in English. Old? I'm sorry. I can't help it. You know. But this magazine has been a boon to this community. Got a big sailing adventure on the Chesapeake Bay about to take place. Well, no, that's not true. It's going to be a while. I received a notice of it. A weekend sailing adventure on the Chesapeake Bay. There's a raffle being run, and their guest will be going on the Hoo Doggy, a 40-foot Pacific Seacraft sailboat. I know the people that own it. I know the people that will be sailing it. But they're sailing, of all places, from Gloucester Point. You know, I used to live there. My family used to live there. On the York River, but that place has changed so much, my goodness. But it's in the Tidewater area. It's on the peninsula. You'll spend Friday and Saturday night aboard Hoo Doggy, a night and day docked at the Cape Charles Marina. Raffle tickets are $25. You can purchase them at the health clinic, 489-7500. Tickets are on sale until April 30th or until sold out. There's a picture of it here. Okay, we got to get a picture so I can show you on the air. Do we have a picture? Kevin, I don't know if you have a picture of the Hoo Doggy. We can show it on the air, because that'd be fun. All right, I believe that is all the announcements I have. And I had some folks in here, and I didn't get a chance to read my little story to you. So I'm going to do that, and then we're going to meet them. All right? Let's see, what is January 6th? The verse is Isaiah 43:2. When you pass through the waters, they will not sweep over you. And I've got a rather lengthy poem here, but I'm not going to read that. But I'll read you the paragraph that is selling that thought. Now pay attention. God does not open paths for us before we come to them, nor does he provide help before help is needed. He does not remove obstacles out of our way before we reach them. Yet when we are at our point of need, God's hand is reached out. Many people forget this truth and continually worry about difficulties they envision in the future. They expect God to open and clear many miles of road before them, but he promises to do it step by step, only as their need arises. You must be in the floodwaters before you can claim God's promise. That's a deep thought, and no pun intended, it just is a deep thought. But you can claim God's promise. Many people dread death and are distressed that they do not have dying grace. Do you know what that is? Of course, they will never have the grace for death when they are in good health. Why should they have it when in the midst of life's duties, with death still far away? Wow, that's a heavy thought. Living grace is what is needed for life's work and calling. And then dying grace is when it is time. Now, that's my about as deep as I want to get. It's a philosophy. It's Christianity. It's from Streams in the Desert, and I enjoy reading that book. All right, I am prepared now to take a commercial break, and I again will show this to you. If you don't have one, you can go get these just about anywhere. And every year, it's bigger and better. So get your book and, heaven knows, learn how to dance. Learn how to go to an event. Athletics for all ages. Then there is that four-pager. And it's not in heavy print, no, it's just like everybody else's, but it's activities for 50 plus. So, that's it in all the announcements and what I have going, and I hope you take advantage. I'm going to call for a commercial now, and we'll sell something, and I'll get my guests in here, and we'll talk about something else this morning. So please stay right where you are.
Look who's playing in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st at the Harvester Performance Center. It's Pam Tillis.
Shake the sugar tree till I feel your love falling.
Three-time CMA Award winner Pam Tillis comes to the Harvester Performance Center in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st.
Maybe it was Memphis. Maybe it was Southern Summer.
Visit harvester-music.com to buy your tickets today or call 540-GUITARS.
We know that there are many options when choosing a healthcare provider for you and your loved one. When your help at home is not enough and you're looking for intense rehab services that home does not offer, at Trinity Mission Health and Rehab of Rocky Mount, our goal is to provide quality healthcare, skilled services to individuals admitted to our facility. Our primary services include nursing services, short-term specialized therapy, which is offered for Medicare as well as Medicaid recipients, respite, bariatric care, as well as long-term care for you and your loved one. We provide physician's coverage by our medical director, Dr. Robert Strong, including an on-site geriatric nurse practitioner as part of that team. In addition to our goal for quality care, Trinity Mission Health and Rehab of Rocky Mount provides a home-like atmosphere for residents to enjoy amenities like in-house movie theater, spacious game room, Wi-Fi, cable, fine dining, as well as private dining. This and many other things are offered at Trinity Mission Health and Rehab of Rocky Mount, where we are serving the needs of our community one patient at a time.
Around here, we drink tea with lunch, dinner, and breakfast. Around here, we get our iced tea from Bojangles, where it's freshly steeped and always served ice cold. Bojangles makes iced tea the only way they know how, the old-fashioned way, because they know that when you serve iced tea all day long, it better be legendary. Bojangles iced tea is freshly steeped for that legendary flavor, all day, every day. Now for only a dollar. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Welcome back to Rise and Shine. Now, what was that that was on the screen? Does that show something, Kevin? Was that the, there it is. Nor'easter snow through noon Saturday. Whoa. So says Rise and Shine. Okay. It's going to be, just be careful, all right? Ladies and gentlemen, you don't want to go out if you can avoid it. And, do you remember when there is no way you would avoid going out in the snow? But I can tell you, see, when I think I discovered it abruptly when I turned 75. Somebody invited me, and I was good for a while, but now I'm way ahead of that. So, but I still enjoy it. I still enjoy it. I walked down to the creek last night, and when I do that, Dee comes out and says, be careful, be careful. I always turn around and say, okay, Mommy. you know who Dee is. She's my very dear wife, and I went down to Furnace Creek. Now, if any of you have a desire to come over and see Furnace Creek, or to see the Washington Iron Furnace, call me at home and I'll take you out back and introduce you to the probably one of the most interesting historical sites in Franklin County. But you can't get there without walking through my yard, so just give me a call and I'll get you back there. It is the only iron furnace still standing in the state. It's about a 35, 40 foot structure. It's worth a look. Major history. And you know where I live. What's the name of the street? Come on, come on. Old Furnace Road. I like to play with them out there, you know. Have we introduced you yet? Yeah. Would you please introduce yourself, and between the two of you gentlemen, tell me what we're going to talk about.
Okay. My name is Steve Thomas. I'm Director of Information Technology in Franklin County.
Yeah. My name is Chuck Kirby. I am the Chief Operations Analyst for Franklin County.
And what we're going to talk about today is a project that we have. It's been approved by the Board of Supervisors, which is to expand the broadband availability in Franklin County. So we want to talk about our roadmap on that and some things going on, and really ask your help.
Okay, all right. What there is, maybe broadband capability, maybe we ought to get an explanation from either or both of you on exactly what that's going to mean, and how will we as a community benefit if there is such a thing?
Okay. Well, broadband is a high-speed internet connection, just as a summary.
I can barely keep up to the one I got now.
It's no surprise to anybody in Franklin County that we're challenged in the internet area. We have some places have good internet, but many, many have little or none.
Yeah, that's always a problem here. Yeah,
it is. And the geography and the distances really challenge us in having internet service providers provide service to the home. So our purpose here, we have a roadmap that was presented to us by CIT. And the first thing on that is to do a broadband survey, finding out what our citizens have in their home, what they need, what their business needs, what their children need, and so on. And I'm going to turn that over to Chuck, because Chuck's our survey guru.
I've never interviewed a guru, so this is going to be particularly interesting. So many things going on these days in Franklin County, and so many advances.
Absolutely.
Now, I'd like to know who this affects.
Absolutely.
Okay, go ahead.
And so why we're doing this this broadband needs assessment survey is because what we are seeking to do here in Franklin County is to improve the access and improve the reliability of broadband throughout Franklin County at the best value for the taxpayers.
Okay.
And how we're doing that is this survey, and we are asking for your help and you know your viewers' help to take 10 minutes out of your day, fill this survey out, because this survey allows us to better understand how people connect to the internet, and then once they are connected to the internet, how do they use the internet. And by better understanding that, we can be better informed on basically using this survey as a foundation upon which to base future decisions. And
who would decisions made by whom? I mean, what is this aimed at?
We are actually quite open to what the possibilities would be based on what the data actually tells us from the survey. But we are looking to engage partners, whether it be other governments, whether it be the private sector, nonprofits, okay. Whatever it takes to be able to leverage resources, to be able to improve the access. There are certain areas in the county that we know have very little or no access, or they have unreliable internet service, and it gets lagged during certain times of the day, things like that. Hmm. We are seeking to be able to do to partner up with whomever we need to partner up with to be able to make that internet access and reliability a little bit better for the citizens and the businesses here in Franklin County.
Wow, that's a big advantage, a big plus for us. If you know, you go Snow Creek and you go to Boone's Mill and you go to all the outlying areas, and there seems to always be a little bit of difference.
Yes,
yes.
Unless you're looking for moonshine, then those areas lead the pack in that. So, oh, that's not what we're heading for. Okay.
But we could do internet research on moonshine.
On moonshine. Whoa. Best offer I've had. This is just to make the system work better. Is that more easy? Is that correct? Easier.
What we want to do is make it easier to obtain internet service.
Okay.
And as many of the people today have inadequate internet service.
Excuse me.
Yes.
That's a great thought. Make it easier to get internet service. I go back a long time, and there was a square block in Rocky Mount. That was the only place you could get it, you know. I'm exaggerating. Relax. But I mean, it was a very small area to provide mm-hmm. service. Now it's growing and growing, and this will benefit the entire community, though, won't it?
Yes, sir.
Better
yes.
service.
Literally everybody, the business community, you know, people, you know, if we're able to eventually, well, when we eventually are able to expand, you know, access and reliability of the internet, more people can work from home. That can be an option. So. Possibly fewer commutes into Roanoke and other neighboring communities. They actually stay here and work in the area. Gosh, there are all sorts of quality of life advantages to this too, not just for the business community, but on a personal level. Do you want to talk about some of those quality of life issues?
Yes. One thing that we hear all the time is how challenged the children are in doing educational work. Many things that the schools would like them to do to learn requires internet access. In some cases, the only internet in the area is the school itself.
Oh, that's so good. Excuse me. I just this morning or yesterday morning, I usually have breakfast with two granddaughters.
Yeah.
And one's a teacher at a farm. And there you're starting to lose something when you get out into that area. Mm-hmm. And the other one's down Sontag.
Okay.
So, you know, and then you stop and think about teachers and what they're doing from the lake to well past farm. And there's the internet itself is a boon, but to think that there are still places where you don't get the same service, or maybe is it such a thing as no service?
Yes, sadly, in some areas, that is the case.
Wow. All right. Now, are you who is directing this? Is it the schools? Is it
No, sir. It's the Franklin County government is the one that's driving this.
Okay.
As I said, we've presented this to the Board of Supervisors, and they are all in. They understand the need for the citizens. So they've given us, at this point, an okay to go forward with the investigation, which is where we are right now.
Wow. This is going to be a real boon if we can get that happening. You know,
yes.
I remember when Christmas time, grandson, we've got 25 grandchildren, and one of the younger ones say, "Were you alive then?" you know, say yeah. But the amazing thing is that there is still, what you're saying is there's still growth out there in this area, and it's needed. Because that while there's limits to where you can go with it in different areas, but there's some areas that don't have that service.
That's true.
And we are hoping to remedy this, but the key is to get as many of your viewers, as many people in Franklin County to fill out this survey as possible. The more data that we have and the better our understanding of what our needs are based on that data, the more sound the decisions will be as far as what's needed and where it's needed in the county.
How does one get to be involved or get that information?
They can, if they visit the Franklin County government website, there is a link on the webpage to take the survey. Now, we also realize, of course, that some people have no internet access or very limited access. And if that's the case, we do have paper copies available at various government buildings and other areas of the community. For instance, we're going to have them in the libraries, the Franklin Center, Parks and Rec building, the Essex Center, and also the Visitor Center for Smith Mountain Lake also has them.
Okay, so if you are interested, if the Chamber is interested, Madam Chamber, then that would be good. I guess that at the Chamber of Commerce office, that should be stocked there.
Yes, it is.
It is. Okay.
And we will also be mailing out copies as well.
Well, this is something. How new is this? I mean, what's its base, and how long has it been since you've been working on this?
When did the project start?
Yeah.
About 2 months ago.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And you just realize, or you have known for a long time that this is needed, tell me very briefly how it will differ for people that today can't do it.
Just make sure I'm understanding your question correctly. You know, how will this affect the viewers and the readers?
Yes,
how will their lives be changed?
It's available for them to use it.
This can be a quality of life game changer. in a variety of areas. People don't realize how much internet affects their lives. Great example, this morning when I woke up, the first thing that I did was to find out what the weather was. And then, of course, that affected what I was going to wear, you know, and decided, you know what, I'm going to need the scarf today. I'm going to need my gloves today. Don't need the umbrella. And then I did a traffic check online to make sure that the roads were still clear. Otherwise, I would have been able to automatically reroute on my navigation software, which is also internet-based. Wow. So what I chose to wear,
past me already.
What I chose to wear, how I decided, you know, what route I took.
I mean, I've got computers in the house, but I don't think I could. Never mind.
And you talk about the evolution. Well, you know, now smart homes. That's the new thing. You've got
home is pretty smart.
Well, you have a device called, you know, from Google called Google Home, and then you have a series of devices. From Amazon, the Alexa, and they can control various devices in your house. For instance, I can turn appliances on and off by my voice. I can dim the lights or turn lights off at will by my voice when I come home. I've got it scheduled so that my lights are already cut on before I walk through the door, so I don't trip over my cat anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, do we believe this man?
And, well, this is going to grow and continue to evolve. This is just the beginning.
That's fun.
And so this literally can change lives. Did you want to talk a little bit about the telehealth and how that can change quality of life?
Briefly, I will talk about that. I saw a demonstration where a nurse could help a doctor who was nowhere near. He was off several miles away. And the nurse helped this lady to be examined with an internet connection. He actually diagnosed a sore throat and told her he was going to prescribe this and it would be at her pharmacy. So she didn't have to go to a waiting room and sit with 20 people who were coughing and wheezing and didn't even have to leave the house. All this could be done in her house, and it could be done with their house when we complete this.
Now that's something that will cost, as it would if you went to see a doctor?
Yes, generally, okay. Yes. But the good part is you don't have to leave your home. Yeah. And if you end up sending your prescription to a pharmacy that delivers, you literally never have to leave home. You know your prescription's brought right to you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that can save you trips to Roanoke, for instance. That can save you gas. That can save you time as well. And like I said, avoiding germs. I mean, this is just fantastic.
I think it's amazing. All the kids, all the grandchildren and great-grandchildren, they come over and they're all really computer smart. Well, of course, Grandpa, we all know more than you, they say, but you know.
They probably do.
I think they do, you know. But this sort of thing is really great. I'd like to have this in my house, in my home. I'm right in town, in the middle, on Old Furnace Road. Why is it called Old Furnace Road? I think I explained that.
You did. I always wondered. I'm glad you did.
But anyway, what a boon! What a neat thing! It'll have to be involved in the education process.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Because people are gonna have to learn. Am I correct? Something new? Something different?
Absolutely. And as time goes on, different departments in the county can offer trainings and classes and things like that to help citizens become more familiar with technology as it advances and continually evolves.
I just had a lesson, as I said, we had a lot of people in the house over Christmas, and I listened to them. Now, those are the same children that used to listen very closely to Grandpa. And now they're, my grandson here in town, Will, he is a whiz at most of those things, and recently got a new piano in the house. The other one was, I don't know, what did somebody say? George Washington must have played on that one or something. Been around for a long time. But anybody needs an old piano? I've got one in my garage. That's an interesting thought. You got to move it yourself, but it's out there. And sorry, something that reminded me. My wife said, get rid of that. But we got this new piano, and there is a new plus. Well, it sounds good. And this will make you smarter. This will give you information.
Yes, sir.
Yes, a wide variety of information. Now, how you use it is up to you. Like I said, it can eventually, affect. I really believe in the near future. We're seeing an influx of more retirees into the community, and based on the telehealth that Steve talked about, it could help you have a better quality of health long term. And as far as smart house technology, you can by powering devices, you can be independent longer, stay in your home longer. And for instance, and even during certain holidays, like you can hook up your Christmas tree to voice-enabled software. So that instead of having to crawl over furniture or whatever to unplug your Christmas tree every night, you can just tell the device turn off
now
the tree.
You're getting close to home. Or trip over 9 wires as you go there.
That's right.
Yeah.
So you can avoid those instances now.
Yeah. Who is doing this? What do you folks represent? The government, the schools, where is this? Who is honchoing this?
Well, we're doing it as the government for Franklin County.
Okay.
And we're working with assistance from Virginia Tech to do the analytics.
At least you got the right school, huh?
Yeah, yes, sir. So they will help us with the analytics about who fills out the survey, where they live, what kind of service they want, what they have, all those things that help us make informed decisions.
And then we've also got the Center for Innovative Technology, a nonprofit that receives state support. They have helped us tremendously with the expertise to help us avoid barriers to success and to be able to leverage strengths. Their staff and resources have helped us tremendously. And as this moves forward, like I said, depending on what the data tells us, we are willing to partner with whomever we need to help, once again, to increase access and reliability throughout the county at the best value for the taxpayers.
And this has got the blessing of the county?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Hey, this is great. I thank you for coming here.
Thank you.
You've piqued my interest. I would love to have that because I have so many people in and out the house. And it's interesting that all my grandchildren, not my children, my grandchildren can help me on a regular basis. We're in the process at home of buying a computer or looking for one. We went rapidly from 3 of them around the house to 1. Now, the kids told me, he said, "Grandpa, the Indians used to use that one." So he said, you're better off. So I've got 2 big open spaces where Dee and I are trying to figure out what to do. Of course, it costs money and you gotta learn it. This looks like a boon for the public to know that this would be available. And I'd like to be involved getting the information out in any way that I can.
Right.
I'd like to see it work. What did we have last year? 2 college graduates, a master's graduate. We got a lot of kids that know the children that say, "Grandpa, are you kidding me?" So give that some thought, because that would be a good way to, I don't know what your plans are, but I am very pleased that you come in and introduced us to it. And this is under the auspices of the county.
Yes, sir.
That's correct.
Okay. Well, if we can be of help, if you need a guinea pig or whatever you have to do, that would be a very interesting thing. Now, one question remains, and then I'll let you go, but I appreciate what you've been talking to us about. Would this mean you have to get a more state-of-the-art computer, or is it just having a place to plug in, or how, I'm not sure. You already, they're both looking at me, ladies and gentlemen, say, "I really understand his problem now." But we're down to 1. We went from 3 computers to 1. So we're thinking about another computer. Mm-hmm. And And the one is a portable one. But what would somebody do, and how could one do that, you know? And is that, am I heading in the right direction?
He's the technology guru, so we'll let him, Steve, take that one.
A different computer or more powerful computer is not necessarily needed. A lot of homes these days have nothing but a tablet, which is an iPad.
Oh, yes.
Even your phone can benefit from it. Your phone can actually send out information through this system we're talking about.
Wow.
So anything that you have, though, will work better with it.
Do you know, excuse me, do you know anything about this?
Yeah.
Oh, shut up. She represents Franklin County. Chamber of Commerce, if you please. But, all right. Well, keep us in the... involved, and... you could make a dear friend out of my wife for life if you could, if we had something like that, you know. So I see great value.
And the biggest way to help is encourage your viewers constantly to fill out the survey. It will be open until February the 28th.
Okay.
And please encourage your friends, your families, your relatives, your colleagues, everybody in Franklin County that you can, to fill out this survey.
How will we get the survey?
It will be available if you go to our county website.
I gotta have a computer.
There's a link there.
Or paper.
Or paper.
But it's also fcbroadbandneeds.org.
Can I do that on my computer?
Yes, sir.
Say that again.
fcbroadbandneeds.
Can't spell broadband need
needs.org.
Okay. .com.
.org.
.org. See, now there's a different one. I don't org much, but I com a lot. All right. Go ahead.
But one thing for your viewers, since you were showing the playbook earlier, there's an advertisement for our website in that.
All right.
It's down in the right corner.
Showing me up on that one, huh?
No.
I will find it.
Okay.
And then we will. I very much appreciate you gentlemen being here. You've opened my eyes, and I know that, you know, it's still in the category of, I didn't know we could do that, you know, or how much will that cost, or what kind of equipment do I have to have? And I don't know. But... it's amazing.
Well, there will be
it's
help.
Interesting to me because I had a lot of smart people when I was running a bank. I was president and chairman of the board of a bank here, and what was in my other title? I had three titles, but never mind. But here in town, that big old building still sits downtown on the corner, and I've retired from that. But I was always amazed at what is happening next.
Oh, and it's continually evolving, and we have the same sort of impression. We're constantly amazed and awed, and we send each other articles constantly when we're doing our research, and we're like, man, this is so cool, check it out. And so we're the same way. It's amazing what can happen and what will happen.
I appreciate you being here.
Thank you for
having
me.
Can you try to come in again sometime as things progress?
Absolutely.
And if there's any way that we can help... my wife would say, stay away from him. He don't know nothing. But I'm really intrigued by it, and I would like to know it. But it's interesting. Because, as I said, all the kids that come in, now, they're all carrying something about maybe smaller than this.
Mm-hmm.
And if, go ahead, show me. Yeah, they are. They can't walk from one place. They'll get up. The Christmas tree was there, and there are presents, and there's things happening. And they get up and go in the kitchen, because you can eat good at my house. And they get there, and they say, you're frantic. What did I do with that thing? I said, oh, that was that over there? I think somebody took that outside. Who took it out? Nobody, you know. But it is part of what happens today.
It is. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And anything we can do as a community, a neighborhood, a school, or Rise and Shine, I think it's probably worthwhile. Thank you for bringing this something, ladies and gentlemen, that's been going on for years that is out there today impressing the heck out of me. And I got to talk to the Chamber of Commerce. Now, she's going to lay some stuff on me, too, probably that I don't know anything about. But, I really did run a bank, a whole bank, many branches. But, never mind. I could say maybe that's when I retired. I don't know. But pay attention. It's very neat. About the time I go to a seven-year-old granddaughter and I say, are you paying attention? And then she starts explaining it to me. I said, I beg your pardon. And then I go to her parents and say she's talking a foreign language. But this is the future. This is maybe considered now and more in the future. So my thanks to you for coming in, Steve and Chuck. This was great information.
Thank you very much.
And if we can assist in any way, be happy to.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Best wishes and good luck.
All right.
Thank you.
I'm on tilt. I'll get back. I got a lady from the chamber coming, and we're going to talk about what live people know. You know how to run a computer. Oh, yeah. So, anyway, this is very nice. And my thanks to you again for making this available to us. And there's a ton of people out there that really want to know more and more and more, you know. And I'm glad that you've taken it on, and our schools are doing it. Okay.
Well, we appreciate the chance to get it out there, so thank you.
Well, let's do some more of it. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a break right now, and then we're going to talk to the, you know who it is. But I'm going I'm going to talk to her about what's going on at the Chamber of Commerce. And please pay attention. We're going to take a commercial break right now. We'll be back. And I'm a little bit intrigued, but I'm more than a little bit, but I'm still puzzled. You know, when you're sitting in home and I can't get the stupid computer to come on, and I call a seven-year-old, do you know how to turn this on? She walks over and looks at me and says, Grandpa, and goes bip, 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 and there's, so, Grandpa, ask Grandma, does Grandma know how to do that? I say, a whole lot more than I do, so. But that's what we're looking at, and you're doing it in the schools and everywhere else. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a pleasure to meet these folks and to talk about this, and we'll try to get some more information from them. But in any event, my thanks. And let's take time for a commercial break. I can do that. So I'll be back in just a moment. Please stay right where you are.
Look who's playing in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st at the Harvester Performance Center. It's Pam Tillis.
Shake the sugar tree till I feel your love falling.
Three-time CMA Award winner Pam Tillis comes to the Harvester Performance Center in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st. Visit harvester-music.com to buy your tickets today or call 540-GUITARS.
My name is Philip Fanot and I run the bakery in Farmville, Virginia. I started this bakery 10 years ago. The whole idea was, I'm from Belgium, I wanted bread, real bread. There was no bread here, so I said, well, I'll make the bread. I have Chantel for internet, phone lines, and also for the credit card processing. If I wouldn't have the phone service or the internet service, I mean, we would be completely out of business because we rely on it very much here. My business runs on Chantel.
Folks, let me tell you about the Duck Inn Market and Deli, located at the corner of Route 122 and Scruggs Road. They've been in business almost 25 years at the same location. They pride themselves on their homemade food from the deli, serving hot breakfast, lunch, and dinner made on the spot. And when's the last time you had a homemade hamburger with melted cheese made the way you like it? Or maybe a hot dog with all the fixings? By the way, they're open at 6 a.m. for you early risers, and you can call ahead if you're in a hurry. With competitive pricing on Exxon gasoline, a large selection of quality groceries, and homemade meals from their deli, you'll want to stop in at the Duck Inn at 122 Scruggs Road at Westlake.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got a little bit smarter talking to those fellas. They're pretty knowledgeable, and they're doing something that needs to be done so that, you know, and probably something that's being done in most homes and in schools, and not something particular that I know. Don't laugh at me, but, you know, I like the computer, but there are so many things more that I can do, learn, and that you can too. And let's face it, that's the future. So, it's quite amazing. Let's take a look at what's going on at the Chamber of Commerce around this county. And your name is?
I am Laura Moritz, and I am the Membership Director for the Smith Mountain Lake Regional Chamber of Commerce. And I manage the Rocky Mount branch.
Wow. That you have an office in the depot?
Yes, we do.
All right. The chamber does?
Yes.
All right. Say your game. Your game.
I got plenty of games.
Watch out for her. Your name again, how you spell it, and where people can go if they are interested in chamber affairs, and when, because I know you have an office in Rocky Mount,
mm-hmm.
and I know the main office is up the road in on the lake, but let's kind of get everybody to know you a little bit better. You're fairly recent in this community.
Yes.
And first time I met you, and I want you to repeat your name time and time again, because people need to know you at the chamber.
Yes, they do.
All right. That's why I'm calling you.
Okay.
And what your role is and how people can... You have donuts?
I do. I'm the guru of donuts. So you were interviewing the second guru of the day.
second thing I've been in awe of. All right, we'll talk more about it.
Yeah, maybe we'll get to the donuts.
How about on a commercial break if I take advantage of her kindness? All right, tell them again out here what your name is, what your job is, and you're part of Smith Mountain Lake and Franklin County and so forth, Chamber of Commerce.
Great.
And then the big office up at the lake. And then where you are here.
Okay, great.
And who you are.
Yeah, okay, great. I'm Laura Moritz, and you spell the last name Moritz.
I believe it or not, I went to school with a Moritz.
Really?
It flows off my lips. So
yeah, it's not very common. Most
first
people.
First name again?
Laura, L-A-U-R-A.
Okay. Yep. You got that, folks? All right. I'm going to write it down, then I won't forget it. I know what it is, but you ought to do it too, because Ms. Moritz is an expert on those kinds of matters, and they're working very hard to keep things going and to allow this county to grow. Now, proceed.
Yeah, while I'm, you know, the larger office, the main office, I guess you would say, is at Smith Mountain Lake at that Bridgewater Plaza. So I'm there kind of half of the week, and then the other half of the week, I am at the depot down on Franklin Street. Now, with winter time, the hours at the depot are more limited. Mm-hmm. I'm usually in town on Thursdays and Fridays up here. Sometimes I'll be in the office. Sometimes I'm downtown or uptown, you know, in the businesses and stuff. So one of the things that we have done is my position has, when they brought me on, was to really strengthen the membership in Rocky Mount and the surrounding Franklin County, and I'm honored, you know, to be in that position. So it's really, once you become a member of the Chamber of Commerce, you're getting two areas for the price of one, because you have the lake area where there's lots of stuff going on, and then you have Franklin County Rocky Mount where there's lots of stuff going on. So one of the other directives that I have been working on and will work on diligently in 2017 is also to get the members from around the lake area and the Mineta, Bedford County, and that area to come out to Rocky Mount more as well.
Oh, that's neat.
You know, so it's there's been a big push, what they call blurring the lines, you know, between the lake area, Bedford County, and then up here into Rocky Mount. So it's an exciting, you know, position for me to be in and be in the mix of that. And it's an honor to be able to represent, you know, specifically the people and the members of Rocky Mount. So
in 2017,
in 2017, I say I'm the cheerleader for Rocky Mount Division. So, and lots of amazing people out here.
Do you know about this? Martin Luther King breakfast?
No.
You should have that posted at the chamber. This is the 15th year. It's at the Pig River Community Center.
Uh-huh.
You know where that is?
I don't, but right. I will after today. Right. I was going to say, you need to start giving me assignments every month. You need to go do this.
This is right in Rocky Mount. If you come into town and you turn left, like you're going to go back out on the big road,
uh-huh,
and you pass a building on the right.
Okay, yeah, okay. I do know where that is.
Well, that's the place where so many good things happen, the Pig River Community Center. And this is January 16th, I can remind people. It's getting close, so you need to get tickets. And this is the first year they're doing it in a, I think, slightly different. You get there, you sit down, you have a nice breakfast, mm-hmm, in their great big room, 100 people, 200 people, however many, and then they have a speaker. And this year's speaker is Judge Charles L. Becton from Durham, North Carolina. So you sit down and you have a nice meal. Everybody that's anybody is there. You'll look around and see policemen, firemen, you'll see all the mayors, you'll see everybody that's involved in this county and town will be there. And the theme of it is living in a changing world. And I'm saying this now because my good friend here hasn't been told. You're still new enough that I'll keep helping you.
So you got to give me assignments every month.
And this is got... For the first time, they're going to have children grades 6 through 12 at this breakfast. I mean, all the mayors and everybody in the community, county, town, lake, comes to this breakfast. But then they're going to, in another large room there, have the Martin Luther King Jr.'s breakfast for youth grades 6 to 12.
Nice.
Guest speaker, Will Smith from Roanoke, and... the tickets for that part of it is only $5. The tickets for the big meeting, Martin Luther King Jr. breakfast, is $15. Both of them are just
a giveaway. But you hear good speakers, you hear a lot of good things, and you get to know a little bit about what's coming on. And you get to see the, and it's, you know where it is, you know, on South Main Street, just going almost out to the big road on the main road here. So that's, all right, enough said about that. But I you know, it came to me.
What time is it at?
8 in the morning. 8 in the morning, and they're both scheduled at the same time. Tickets for adults are 15 that are going into that room, and then tickets for the youth are $5, grades 6 through 12. And everybody's invited.
Nice.
And you learn some good stuff.
Okay.
And you meet all the mayors, all the town councils, anybody that's anybody is there. I haven't missed
Sounds like I need to be there.
One would suggest.
Yes.
It was just a real bold attempt at a thought for her.
Excellent.
Okay. I'm sorry. Where were we?
No, that's great.
What else is going on at the lake?
Well, the reason I brought the donuts is that, well,
because
this is
really
this is
like
not
me.
I do like you. I do like you a lot. And it's not just an empty box. There is donuts in here.
Okay.
But this is not at the lake. This is right here in Rocky Mount. Daylight Donuts. And I brought this because we are going to have a ribbon cutting at Daylight Donuts.
So I can write that on here.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
On January 20th at 11:30 to 1, it was kind of like the open house.
January 20th?
Uh-huh. And we will actually cut the ribbon at 12:15.
Cutting. 12:15.
Now, have you been to Daylight Donuts yet?
My family has. They've told me about it.
See, now I'm teaching you something right here in Rocky Mount.
Gee whiz, here we go. I got to be beholden to her.
But
no, that's it. Ribbon cutting is at the place.
Mm-hmm. And they're on Old Franklin Turnpike right behind the McDonald's, in that plaza right behind the McDonald's.
Oh, near Mickey D.
What else is in that complex? Roses, I think, is in that. Roses, isn't that the other store that's in that complex there? Yeah.
Right behind the McDonald's there. So it's going to be in that little shopping center.
It'll be at the Daylight Donuts there. Yeah, and they're located right there, right behind the McDonald's in that complex.
And I get to have a donut.
Those are yours. I brought them for you.
If anybody
And your cameraman, of course. You got to share a little.
I don't know. If he's good today, I'll...
But they are excellent. They are really good.
Wonderful. Thank you. And that's good to hear that news. I appreciate that very much. Keep talking. You're on a roll.
Yeah. Well, also, I was going to say, kind of going back to, you know, how people who are interested in becoming part of the Chamber of Commerce, or if they just want to come out and see what we're doing here in Rocky Mount, the second Wednesday of every month at 9 a.m. at the depot, mm-hmm. we have what is called a Connect meeting.
Oh, yes, I'm familiar with
that. Okay, so it's the Chamber of Commerce Connect meeting. And every month, I mean, we have anywhere from 30 to 50 chamber members and their guests. You don't have to be a chamber member to attend. They come out, and we usually have a speaker, you know, from somebody in town sharing news about what's going on. And then different people from Rocky Mount will kind of tell what's kind of going on in their, you know, sector. So it's networking, getting to, you know, what's going to be going on in town that month, and then, you know, how you can become part of the chamber and support, you know, the growth of the business community in Rocky Mount.
And you said second Monday?
The second Wednesday.
Wednesday.
So this month it'll be the 11th, I believe, at 9 a.m. at the depot.
January 11th. 9 a.m. All right.
Because it's growing. You know, the Chamber of Commerce here in Rocky Mountain, it is growing. We are on the upswing. And in 2017, we've got a lot of exciting things that we're going to be planning.
That's a very neat idea. And I can add this to my offerings every show to remind people that this is going to happen at the train station in Rocky Mount, right downtown. You know where it is. And it's a second Wednesday part of the chamber.
Yep.
That they're going to continue to have, and where and what, I don't know. But this one is on January 11th, just a few days away, at 9 in the morning. And if you haven't been to the depot, you should come. And it has a limit as to people, but we've never reached that, maybe once or twice. But we like it when that gets filled up. And learn about, what are you dealing with there on the second Wednesday at the depot when you have this meeting?
We like I said, we usually have a guest speaker. Lots of times it's, you know, an official from the town. Something, an educational portion of, you know, of the meeting. Wow. Things that you should be aware of that's going on, you know, in Rocky Mount.
That's nice.
And then, you know, the other business owners in Rocky Mount are there, and they share a little bit about their business and what's going on, challenges they may have. Because at the end of the day, the Chamber of Commerce, you know, our goal, our mission is to support, you know, the growth of businesses. So,
unless the snow is 40 feet deep,
right?
I plan on being there.
Oh, nice.
January 11th. Gosh, that's...
That's next week.
Next week, okay.
Yep.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
You're not sitting still, are you?
No. There's always something new, that's for sure.
All right, well, keep talking.
Yeah. Well, we also brought this nice little photo here so that you could see. Now, have you seen the Virginia's for Lovers, and lots of the towns and cities have their version of love letters, right? So this is our version of the love letters, and you can go see those, and that's at Booker T. Washington Highway. You know where the Kroger is on Booker T. Washington Highway? The actual address is 13020.
As you right out at the corner?
Yeah, if you're coming from Rocky Mount, on the right-hand side, you see the Kroger. So just past the Kroger at West Lake Plaza, those are right out front, right on the road. So they're installed permanently so that people can go out there and get their pictures taken in front of our love letters. So every town has a different theme across Virginia. And I think I counted like 60 different cities that have a version of their love letters. But our version, as you can see, the L is a water ski, you know, made of water skis. The O is a golf ball.
Let's see if we can get this on while we're talking about it.
Yeah, the V is like fishing lures. And then the E is made out of buoys. So it's a rendition of the lake there. Yeah,
look
there
at
you
that.
Got
Isn't
it.
That neat? Now, who are those people?
That's the Chamber of Commerce staff.
Probably the newest one out there.
Yeah, but. Andrea Fansler is too.
Okay.
So that's me there with my little jazz hands, right?
I could tell that.
And that's Annette Stamus, and she does all of our marketing. And then that's Andrea Fansler. She came aboard the chamber about the same time I did, and she does all of the events. And of course, that's Vicki Gardner. Everybody knows Vicki. This right here is Laura Healy, and she is the office manager and accounting. So she runs the office there at the lake and all the volunteers. And this is Barb Nocera. So she does special projects. She actually does a lot of helps with the political, or what would you say, new things coming down the pike. Example, like they were here just talking about the internet and the broadband and stuff.
Yeah.
She works a lot on those types of projects.
Who are we talking about now?
Barb Nocera.
Barb Nocera,
yeah. So I call her the mover and shaker. So she's out there making the wheels turn on new projects coming into the area.
It's a good picture. It's nice, and it's got a very neat basis. Love.
Yeah. So those are installed right out there permanently. So anybody can go out there and have their pictures taken with them. A lot of people, when they have guests come to visit, they'll take the guests out there and get their photo with it.
This is so. At the chamber's office.
No. That is, those love letters are installed right there past the Kroger on Booker T. Washington Highway at the Westlake Plaza. It's
I see the water behind it.
Well, that when we used it, that we hadn't unveiled it yet. So we took that picture. It was down by the office there. But then we actually installed it permanently up there, you know, further up the road, so that more people could get to it and take their pictures. So that when people are driving in,
so this is and actually it's closer where your office is.
Yeah, that's like up the road. Okay. And it's closer to where, you know, between Rocky Mount and, you know, the Bridgewater. So that's kind of right there, you know, closer towards Rocky
Mount. Picture.
So, yeah, so people can go out there and get their pictures taken and have fun with it. And so.
As you have time, somebody could send us one of these pictures. We could use them.
Yeah, we could do that. Now, also, too, while people are traveling around Virginia and you want to see the other versions of, you know, the different cities' love letters, they can actually go to virginia.org, and it gives you a whole listing of where love letters are all across the state. And everybody's love letters are different. So it's really neat to even go on the website and see the different themes that everybody has. So so that's just something fun.
Wow.
So if you're out there traveling around Virginia, make sure you go to the website and see where else you can see letters.
And
Daylight Donuts, Daylight January Donuts, 20th.
It's a new place out there. And they're talking to me now. See that?
They were actually at the Franklin County Christmas. The
Coming Home to a Franklin.
Yeah, the Coming Home to a Franklin. They were out there as well. And so I bought a donut that night and had it the next morning. And it was still fabulous. So.
All right. Still fabulous Daylight Donuts.
Yes.
And did we get an address on these people?
It's on Old Franklin Turnpike, right behind the McDonald's.
Right behind the McDonald's. Okay. You know where that is. I'm going to go out there. Okay. Why not? You know, there's lots of good things happening, and that is very neat. All right. Next.
Next. I have a question to ask you. After the conversation that you had with the guest before me, what kind of phone do you have? Do you have a phone that has internet on it?
Let me see. I don't know what kind of phone that
is.
I left it out in the car.
I had to tease you a little bit.
Yes, I don't know. I have a phone that is probably that big, that small, and
tell me it doesn't flip open.
It flips open.
Okay.
Shut up. And I can phone anybody that I want to.
That's all you need, right?
That's right. And but there are other uses, and as a situation presents itself, I learn something. But no, it's not sophisticated at all. But anyway, I'm not in charge of sophistication.
I hear you there.
But when I am with grandchildren and children, Will, my 19-year-old, just turned 19, grandson that lives here, has been shopping for new
phone, tablet,
so whatever you call it.
Yeah,
I'm afraid to say now, but and he has, you know, he understands the sophistication of it.
Yeah, he's a smart one.
Yeah, and the teachers that are my grandchildren that are in various schools in Franklin County, they understand it. Grandpa does not. But I'm okay. I don't want to learn too much. And I really don't mean that. But it's amazing. That's very nice. And that's a good thing. That's right out there at the chamber office.
Yeah, that was one of the projects that we did for the 50th anniversary of Smith Mountain Lake.
Okay.
And so, yeah, they're installed permanently.
I've seen that or something similar at an eatery up from where they have lots of big things on their miniature golf course.
Oh, okay.
you know,
yeah.
that are like that sized things. Uh-huh. That's right up close, more closer to the corner.
Okay.
There's, if you going out towards where your office is, and they're back on the right. And they serve good food, and they have a little miniature golf course and have this kind of thing out there.
Oh, are you talking about Hot Shots?
Yeah.
Yes, I love Hot Shots. Yeah, we order lunch from there all the time.
All right.
And they deliver it right to the chamber office.
I didn't know that,
and
see?
And it's very good.
All right. How much do you get for that interesting thing? Because that's good.
Yeah.
We got to support everybody.
Yes, we do.
I didn't know, for example, that Hot Shots would deliver something. There you go. All right. Neat stuff. Neat stuff. Okay. What else are we going to talk about?
For 2017, you know, like I said, I really want to, you know, start building, you know, the presence of Rocky Mount and getting out there and getting new members to join us. You know, I always say we're only as strong as our membership.
Yeah.
So, that's you know, true. Every business that joins helps the other businesses, you know, in the membership. So.
I think that the reason that maybe there is a difference is because Rocky Mount has a different style.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And different needs.
Than Smith Mountain Lake or than Roanoke or than Bedford or something like that. It's a better place to live, in my humble opinion. And we have now lots of grocery stores and lots of neat things going on. And the chamber opening an office, you know, in the depot there, that's very nice, and that's going to get us on the map.
Yeah, you know, I say it again and again, is that we're only as strong as our membership. And the goal, you know, of the Chamber of Commerce, you know, is to support the local businesses, to have it grow. So, you know, the more people that join, the stronger we are. So, like you said, you know, Rocky Mount has different needs than Smith Mountain Lake, than Bedford, than Roanoke. And the only way for us to meet those needs is to, you know, is to bond together as members. So it's an exciting thing. So.
Wow, that's good. Laura is right in the middle of it, and I'm so glad that you're here and taking steps to bring all of us together more.
Yeah.
It's not the Chamber of Commerce at the Lake, or the Chamber of Commerce in Rocky Mount, or the Chamber of Commerce at Ferrum, but it turns out that the some groups have functions in all those areas,
mm-hmm.
but
yeah.
The Chamber of Commerce needs to be in all those areas, and that's very nice. That's
yeah,
very
we're
nice.
A large group of people, mm-hmm. and each section has its own needs, and you know everybody can support each other to make sure that everybody's needs are fulfilled.
And so. As it grows, look at this. I got this from the public library. Look at all that. All the things this month at the public library, of which you have a store out there at the lake. And
mm-hmm.
who's that? Quickly, Jackson.
Wow. Yeah, there is so much to do in this area that is.
And if some of it's out at the Lake Library, some of it's at the Rocky Mount Library, Smith Mountain Lake Library, but there's all of this around there, just as you said, Laura, about everybody sharing and everybody doing and everybody getting information.
Right. Yeah.
Wow.
And you're a vehicle of that.
I guess I am a vehicle
of that. Absolutely.
I don't mind being a vehicle.
No.
That's good. I think I was looking at the library events this morning and I read off some of them, but they're amazing what they do in the library, for example.
Well, that's how I got to see the furnace.
Okay. That's right.
Because they
you
sponsored
were there.
It. Yeah. I even went to the library, got on the bus, and they took us over there.
That's right.
Or the shuttle bus.
Not long after you came here.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was my first week.
First week, yeah.
Here. that we did.
Well,
that.
We gotta train you right, you know.
You are.
Yeah.
You are.
But you're picking up on it. You don't need me, but you're doing well. All right, what else is up that we should talk about? I mean, we've talked about it plenty, but...
Yeah, well, you know, this is also that time of year that we start collecting volunteers for all of the events. You know, so we've got the, you know, of course, the wine festival, and we've got the Rockin' Beer and Barbecue Festival. Mm-hmm. That is actually in downtown Moneta. Anyway, all the events that the Chamber does throughout the year. This is the time that Andrea Fansler, you know, she starts planning and getting her committees together, mm-hmm. getting the volunteers together. So anybody who wants to be involved in any of those events and that are, you know, lots
of fun. You have
things
for them to do.
Absolutely. So they can contact Andrea and she can get them set up on a committee for an event that, you know, fits what they like to do. And yeah, so that's the, you know, anytime you go into January, it's planning for the rest of the year. So January is just, it's a planning month.
It's amazing because I just received this in from the library, and as we were talking, we were fanning the offerings at the libraries mm-hmm. in Franklin County. And our guests today have a varied approach to what's going on. The gentlemen that we're in first are installing or being involved in new lines of communication.
Yeah, that's important.
And it really is amazing. What else are you involved in that we can talk about?
What else am I involved in? I just stay really busy.
Okay.
Out there just, you know, meeting people and... we have, of course, the Chamber of Commerce. We've got the annual awards coming up, and that is basically the members vote on certain categories. And so those will be announced. With those are all kept under wraps. So we'll have that coming up by the end of the month, kind of announcing those members in the community who have excelled in their division.
There's so many things going on in our community.
Yeah, there really is.
It's really amazing. If you tune in, or if you tell your friends to tune in Cable 12, they may not particularly want to look at me, but they can hear me, and we can talk all month about what's going on around this community. And you get to meet the guests I've had today, which were very nice people, and even you, and that's nice.
So now Andrea did say that she missed you, and she's going to have to come on with me the next time.
All right.
Or two.
Thanks for the warning. I mean, thank you for bringing her in.
Yeah.
Nice people, but that's the basis for letting the world know.
Yeah.
Just exactly what is here. Right now, it's cold. But the interesting thing is, maybe it will snow. Now, that's this where we are is what causes that, the geographics of it. And sometimes it's a terrible big snow, and other times it's...
Yeah, last night my daughter was hoping it would snow, and I said, it can't, I have to go on Rise and Shine in the morning.
I'm glad you're so excited about
it. I do. I enjoy this.
What else can we close with? Is there anything else out there that needs support or that you can share?
I will be throughout 2017, I will be doing segments at the depot and also at around the lake.
Segments of what?
Maximizing the chamber membership.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of other things that a chamber membership can do for you. Mm-hmm. I mean, the marketing is amazing what it can do on very, you know, low budget. And so I will be giving seminars. So the next time I'm here, I'll be able to give you some dates.
Okay.
Of, you know, some seminars that I will be doing that people can come to and see what's up.
Kind of around the county in various places or at
well,
the chamber?
Well, in the Rocky Mountain, I'll be doing it at the depot.
The depot. Okay.
The depot needs, you know, it's a great space.
Yeah.
And so also, if anybody doesn't know out there, that, you know, they do rent out the depot there, and they also have in the back there, they have a very nice conference table with nice chairs, and so I'll be using the conference room at the depot for those, because it's I couldn't ask for a better space to do it. It's very nice and comfortable, and so.
This is as you come into town and you turn right to go downtown, the depot, you know the depot is on your right very quickly, and it is a historic site.
I love being there.
And that's the caboose is a historic site.
Neat.
And you can rent it if you want to, you know, but it's really a neat thing. And Laura's office is there. She's there part of the week.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty neat. I'm glad that we're doing it that way.
Yeah, I mean, they rent it out for baby showers, for family reunions, for all sorts of stuff. So,
you know, I really like that fact, because I have used it on occasion for that sort of thing. Isn't this nice?
Yeah, well, and that's where we have our Connects meetings, like we said earlier. I mean, and what a comfortable space to be in. You know, you can fit plenty of people in there. And then it doesn't hurt that it's has that historical tug to it. It's not just a white room with four walls.
All right. Are you prepared enough to give us a dissertation on the depot? What it was, when it was?
You're gonna have to have Will for that.
Oh yeah, he can do it,
though. I know he can.
You know the depot downtown. You know the fact that it's there. Why is it there? When was it put there? And what are its secrets? Now I got you trapped. You want to learn about it. It's a historical site in this county and town. So it's great. All right, I think we have talked ourselves into a corner.
Well, I always enjoy coming.
Yes. Well, I am glad to see you. This is a very neat picture.
We'll send you that.
All right. Do that. Except for the one on the left end. I'm sorry. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And Mother Gardner in the middle.
Yes. I'll tell you what, I am blessed to work with her.
Well, you tell her I agree with that. And she's a great person, does great things. And if you haven't been down to that, or if you haven't been down lately, take a trip to the chamber at the lake, at Smith Mountain Lake, and also to the chamber office. And what are the hours that you're there in Rocky Mount at the depot?
Well, because it's the winter time, you know, the hours are, they don't have the, it's not open regularly, you know, except for to rent. Mm-hmm. So I'm usually in town on Thursdays and Fridays. From 12 to 4 is usually safe. Sometimes I'm there earlier, sometimes I'm there later. But usually Thursdays and Fridays.
You're a moving target.
I am. But right. I can't stay in an office. I need to be out there with the business owners. I need to be out there in the community.
Well, thank you for keeping us in mind. Thank you for bringing us up to date and for learning all the things that we learn.
Well, thank you for having
me on. This is Laura Moritz. And, you know, and go out either to the depot in town or the chamber office out at the lake, or anywhere that she's liable to be, and get to know her. She's the big cheese out there with dealing with getting people in to do things that are valuable to the community.
Yeah.
And she doesn't think I know that she's a big cheese, but she is, and I care for her a great deal. And if you need something to do with that part of the county, talk to her about it. And she can be found at one of those two places, I guess, unless she's out gallivanting and visiting businesses.
Drumming up new members.
Okay. Thank you for being here
today.
Thank
you for having me. I always enjoy it.
Yeah, it is fun. Me too. The feeling is mutual. Ladies and gentlemen, we made all the announcements. I've got that big pile from the library, and I'm going to have to get that together so that I can tell you more things that are going on. But it's wonderful to live in Franklin County. It's wonderful to be here, except when you're either at this point in time, your air conditioner goes on the fritz, or worse yet, your heater goes on the fritz at home, your burner, I've got to call my favorite person to come over and check that, but I also, you know, we've been away up in Northern Virginia. We were up in the Spotsylvania area and visiting family, and I saw most of the ones that were down here, but then we ran up there, and it's so many good things going on around the state, but I think we've got a corner on it here. I think there's more things available here.
I agree.
I'll give you the last word if you have anything to say.
Go to Daylight Donuts.
Go to Daylight Donuts.
The Donut Guru has spoken. But a Daylight Donuts would definitely be at the ribbon cutting.
Did we talk about exactly where this is?
Yeah, we did.
Okay.
Yep. Behind the McDonald's.
Behind the McDonald's.
On Old Franklin Turnpike.
Everybody knows where the McDonald's
yep,
are.
Yep, so it's right behind there in that complex. So.
Behind McDonald's when you turn.
If you turn in to go to McDonald's.
How about if you turn in to go to the bank right there? But that goes around behind.
Next to the Roses.
Yep. Roses.
It's right
I'm
next to
thinking
it, right
wrong
next,
corner.
Yeah, it's right next to the Roses in front of, behind McDonald's.
All right, in that little shopping center there. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep.
So, if you know McDonald's, or you know Roses, or you know that area, go down to that office. And you'll meet this lovely lady who is doing such a great job in bringing the world to Franklin County. Please stay warm. Big deal. It's getting cooler right now. They have forecast snow. They did for today. It's not going to happen, it appears, but they are going to have warnings again for tomorrow. So, you know, just be careful. Be careful. Dress warmly. That same grandson says, warm dressly, and have a good time. I'm glad that you watched today, and my thanks to you and all the good people that come in and talk to us. And if all goes well, I'll see you all again next time, and God bless you all.
Look Who's Playing in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st at the Harvester Performance Center. It's Pam Tillis.
Shake the sugar tree till I feel your love falling.
Three-time CMA Award winner Pam Tillis comes to the Harvester Performance Center in Rocky Mountain, Saturday, January 21st. Visit harvester-music.com to buy your tickets today or call 540-GUITARS.
Doyle Custom Embroidery is your family-owned, faith-based choice for custom embroidery, screen printing, and heat printing right here in Franklin County. If you want to improve your business's image, promote your event, or just create your own custom product, then Doyle Custom Embroidery is your choice. We can embroider anything that will hold a stitch. Check out our huge selection of quality products at dceestore.com. And remember, we'll keep you in stitches.
Here at A Nurse's Touch Home Care, we are the area's leading in-home care provider. We offer the very best compassionate care for all of our clients.
I think that we were richly blessed, my mom and I, when we got a hold of Nurse's Touch. Because you couldn't ask for anyone any better. They are just like a family. I love them.
For assistance, you may call 540-238-5056 or you may visit our website at www.anursestouch.net.